I can report that the weather in Tokyo is quite hectic at the moment. We have heavy rainfall and we have a thunderstorm, so we got some, what we call in recording, some real effects instead of digital effects to give some extra ambience. I know we have on the line, we're going to have Asbi coming on board and Watanabe-san, if you can switch on your video. I think we just switched off.
Yep, mine was disabled. Let's see.
Yeah, no, we, you know, we,
Shortly.
yes, we were switching from one to the other, so sorry about that.
There we are.
Watanabe-san,
Hello.
ビデオオンお願いします。
なんかホストが停止してるからできない。
Okay.
そうそう、もう一回やってみてください。
あの、止まった。
今大丈夫と思います。はい、ありがとうございます。
はい、どうも。
はい、じゃあ、ちょっとジャズをゆっくり聴いてから少しなんか、心が優しくになって、ありがとうございます。で、多分先に、ちょっとアズビーの方が今、どこにいますか？アズビー、where are we today? Where are we right now?
今は、we are now in Nakano of Futaba. And it's, これはね、Nakano Restart Base という。It's called the Nakano Restart Base. And I will flip my camera around a little bit. You can see a little bit. In the distance, you see some kind of modern buildings.This is a short distance from the ocean. 海から近いところでこの建物がありますから。That's the new museum of the disaster. 伝承館という建物とコミュニティセンターなんですけど、周りが何もないですよ。で、これはかなり被害が多かったところで、海の方は今車の中だけど、これが新しい堤防。で、建設ばっかり。で、これはまだまだ、原っぱばっかり。So this is lots of construction infrastructure, totally vacant lots and these new, very expensive new facilities, intended to help restart the community here. So ここから後で私たち、ここからちょっと隣の浪江町の請戸というところ行ったりして、やりますから、いろいろ見ますね。で、とにかくここで、記憶というテーマですね。This area around here we're thinking is the theme is for memory.How is the disaster being memorialized? And, what are the ways that it's done well and the ways that maybe it could be done better? ということで、ちょっとカメラが戻しますね。はい。So, 渡辺さんたちが、今日はちょっと話聞きたいと思いましてね。
そうですね。Asbi さん、ありがとうございます。
Yeah.
Thank you so much.I think it would be great if it's kind of confusing, I think, for people that are watching us. We have two Watanabe-san at the same time. And I'm going to briefly talk about the two Watanabes, but I think the best thing is both Watanabes tell their story today.
Toshikatsu to Watanabe Norio-san, Mr. Watanabe Toshikatsu and Mr. Watanabe Norio, they both live in Koriyama, 2人とも Koriyama 出身 and that is Fukushima 県の真ん中の方ね。It's in the center of Fukushima. そこの条件が、ここの浜通り、海辺とかなり違うし、いろいろなことあるから。The situation for the center of Fukushima is very different from the situation on the coast. It's also very different from the western part, Aizu, where Jun Yamadera is from. So, じゃあ、Watanabe さんたちが、じゃあ、まあ、自分のセーフキャストの話を聞きたいと思いますから、じゃあ、10年前と今からってちょっと話したらどうかなと。
Okay.
Who wants to go first to talk about, their relationship to Safecast, their Safecast story, and 10 years ago, and what about the future? Watanabe Toshikatsu. Actually,
okay.
We call, just いいですか?
Okay.
私たちね、Watanabe Toshikatsu さんがの方が年上から私たち Big Watanabe という。それで Watanabe Norio さんが年下から Little Watanabe という。だけど、実は大きさは違う。So, we call Mr. Watanabe Toshikatsu Big Watanabe because he's senior. And then Norio, we call Little Watanabe, although he's actually bigger. So, it's just one of those things. じゃあ、よろしくお願いします。
はい。では私の方から
Okay, from Mr. Watanabe.
はい。
確かに、いや。
だから
都市で通訳しますからね。
うん。 セーフキャストとの出会いというのは本当に2011年の4月、原発から1ヶ月ちょっと経って、まあ、それまでもずっと原発が壊れたから、やっぱりその自分たち郡山でも、どれぐらいその線量が高いのかということはわからないままにいたわけですね。
So, he's saying that, he first, you know, made contact with, Safecast or New Safecast in April of 2011. So it's been several weeks since the beginning of the accident, but the accident was continuing. And, he, like other people in Koriyama, were concerned to know about the radiation levels.
で、まあ、そういう時に、Safecastと、まあ、ピーターたちと初めて、郡山に来てもらった時に初めて会って、それで、そこから、まあ、郡山市内だけではなくて、いろんなところを、まあ、一緒に、この、これね、This one. Here,、This is a prototype of PIGIG. これを、これでもって、一緒に、いろんなところを測って回ったということですよね、最初は。
So, in April of 2011, Toshikatsu Watanabe met Peter.And, you know, began to have conversations and started to go around, not just in Koriyama, but other parts of Fukushima as well, carrying this Geiger counter here, which is kind of where the Bigaigi came from. This is the Medcom inspector made in the United States by our good friend Dan Saifi. So,
だから、こういうことをやりながらもうすでに、まあ、Bigaigi も進化して、ずっと計測活動をしているわけですけど、ちょうど今から3年前ですかね、いわゆるレイおじいさんが郡山に来て、で、日本大学の郡山校で、セミナーっていうか、そういうことをやった、その時に初めて、いわゆるレイさんの新しいタイプの、放射線量だけではなくて、PM2.3 とか 2.5 を測る。そういう新しいデバイスを開発を し始めたという話を聞いたので、
いいですか。And then, since that time, he continued, you know, being active with Safecast, and, you know, supporting in many ways. And in thinking about Koriyama, 3 years ago, Ray Ozzie came, along with others of us, and there was, Watanabe-san organized a very big seminar.And Ray spoke at that seminar, and that was when, you know, we learned about the new sensor that Ray was designing that also measure particulate, so PM, and he became very interested in that as well.
なので、まあ、ずっと、まあ、福島県内で放射線量を測ってきたんですけど、もう一つは、まあ、市内の高校生と一緒に B 外技の、組み立てのワークショップを何回かやってきたので、まあ、そういう意味では、その単に放射線量を測るということではなくて、いわゆるシチズンサイエンスみたいな、そういったことを、まあ、郡山で、ある程度こう、広げるような、広がるような、そういうことも合わせてやってきたんですね。
Yeah. So, of course, he was continuing to measure, monitor radiation, using big IGs, et cetera. But, he also,got very interested in the educational side and helped organize workshops at high schools in Koriyama, because it's not just about, you know, measuring radiation. He's very interested in supporting the whole idea of citizen science and teaching young people, like high school kids, about the value and the potential benefits of that. So, you know, in Koriyama, that's his home base, so he's doing this in Koriyama.
なので、今は、今度は、こういった、BIG で計測するということから、いわゆる空気全体ね、いわゆる郡山福島県内の空気を測って、まあ、放射線量だけではなく、レイオジーの仕組みを使って、新たにシチズンサイエンス的な立場で、計測活動をもっと、広げていきたいというふうに今計画しているところなんですね。
And now, you know, he's still moving forward, planning, for instance, how to have all of the city of Koriyama measured, you know, regularly monitored the air in Koriyama, not just radiation, but also air quality, particulate, et cetera, in Koriyama. And to try to, you know, get the interest growing in that and in that sense, Watanabe-san がよくあの市の市長とか話したりしてるんですね。He often has, he has connections with the、local government, with the mayor, and has introduced us to him as well. So, そうですね。
で、合わせて郡山市がその SDGs 都市になって指定されているんですね。
Yeah, the city of Koryama is very enthusiastic
about
the UN SDGs, the social development goals. Very serious about implementing those and becoming a leader in that.
なので、まあ、カーボンニュートラルも含めて、あのメジャーメントをいろいろさまざまにこれから、あの、
In the goals of becoming carbon neutral, measurement is very, very important. So, and again, there is some interest from the city government in SafeCast systems on that, and we still have some projects in development. So, いいですね。じゃあ、いいですか、のりおさんにちょっとバトンタッチしましょうか。Yeah? And can you translate? Yeah. And 今、M さんがちょっと通訳しますね。
Okay. Does this work?And I can also... Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Emo, loud and clear. As we should unmute.
So maybe...
Howling system.
So use this one. Okay.
Okay.
You hear? Okay.
大丈夫?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. こんにちは。なんだろう、としかさんと同じ郡山にいる、高校の教師をしてます渡辺と申します。よろしくお願いします。あの背景に映ってるのは私のクラスの高校生、女子高生なんですけど、ワークショップをした時のものです。
I'm a teacher in Koriyama at a high school, at a girls high school, and in the background you can see my students.
私とセーフキャストは実は、私も独自で別にですね、県内、福島県内の線量測定をしてました。で、
I have actually been doing、radiation measurements by myself within Fukushima after the accident.
で帰ると当時線量計が高くて手に入らないんですよ。
ものすごく。At that time, the radiation measurement devices were too expensive to buy. All of these.
でも避難してきた人が私の家のすぐ近くに2300人いて、ボランティアに入って、帰れるかどうかっていうのを質問攻めになったんですね。で、それで線量計もない。で、危険かどうかもわからない。で、機械は高くて買えないし、品薄で全くわからないので、どうにかしてほしいっていうので、線量計をじゃあ作っちゃえ。ということで、必死に作りました。
There are more than 2,300 people who evacuated who came near our place, and they asked us how high the radiation was if they were able to go back. But the problem was that there was were no measurement devices, and even those ones which existed were too expensive to get. And that's when I decided to make my own measurement devices.
いろいろ作ってて、市販しているものは高いんですけど、福島県の状況では超高線量、数十マイクロとか100マイクロシーベルトを超す場所もあったり、0.1 マイクロシーベルトっていう低いところもあって、例えばこれは9.9 マイクロシーベルトしか測定できないんですね。ですから富岡とか今安住さんたちがいるところは使い物にならないんですよ。それで
高専
用のやつを 作ろうとしました。
Okay. Okay.
So the problem was that the radiation measurements were varying all over Fukushima. There were high places and low places, and in the low places it were sometimes up to a couple of hundred.
High places, micro seagulls, up to hundreds.
And that, for example, for this device I have right now, you can only measure until 9.9. And that means in some places, this device is useless. And that's why we developed something which could also measure at these places.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
で、線量計で測れるのっていうのはこう 1点1点1点で、視覚化できないんですよね。そこの場所に行ってじっと測定して、でそれをやってる時にセーフキャストと偶然出会ったんですね。でそれでセーフキャストのやっている活動が線量計とか、あと新型のこういう GPS 搭載の B ガイディとかを使うと視覚的に面的にマップが作れるっていうことを知ってボランティアに協力しました。
The problem with the devices which existed at that time was that you could only make measurements, punctual measurements, so it was difficult to make the radiation visible or recognizable. And then when I met SafeCast, I heard that they had combined it with the GPS, which made it visually seeable or mappable. And that's why I decided to be a volunteer of SafeCast.
で、これが、B ガイディで、私も県内あちこち測定して、まあ、いろんな人のボランティアさんのデータ集約した、視覚した、これ福島県のマップなんですね。で、ここが多分、今、この辺にいるのかな、アズビーさん。これ第一原発、これ J ビリッジ、第一原発、多分、浪江請戸ですね。うんでずっとこう福島市の北上していってこう福島市がこう汚染したんですね、まあ、ここは今帰還困難区域ですからで、どうぞどうぞ
This map which you see in the back is map taken by B-Gaigis by volunteers all over Fukushima and I myself have also collected a lot of this data and you can see on this map the J village on the south side Fukushima Daiichi and then Namie, and if you go all the way up north, you can see that the radiation has also gone through Fukushima City.
で、ここが私が住んでいる郡山なんですよ。
And this is where I live. This is 郡山。
で、ここのとこ見てもらうと真っ赤なんですね。
で、これ。In this map, you can see that here it is red. The radiation is white.
ここ私の実家なんですよ。
This is where my house is.
二本松市です。
And this is 二本松。
で、国が出したモニタリングポストとか、線量計で一個一個測定したやつでは、ここがこんなに汚染してるっていうのは誰も気がつかなかったんです。で、セーフキャストの B ガイギーのこのマッピングをしていく中で、こう日本松っていうのがとてつもなく広範囲に汚染してるっていうのが分かったんですよね。
And from the governmental monitoring posts or the measurements from other measurements, it was not clear that Nihonmatsu had such high radiation. And it was through the monitoring of the Bigaigis that became clear that Nihonmatsu had high radiation in a white area.
ということで、セーフキャストがやってくれたものっていうのは、福島県民が自分が住んでいる場所が どういう状態なのかを視覚的に表現できた。で、それで自分たちがこう住んでる場所の安全性を確認できたっていうのが一番大きいと思いますね。で、今現在も測定をし続けて、これがどんどんこう青色に変わっていくっていうのを視覚的に見れる。そういう活動を今も続けてます。
I think the biggest contribution of Safecast is that they have made it, make the radiation visible and understandable for everyone so that the people who live in Fukushima can actually see and see at the map, look at the places where they live and can see whether it is safe or not. And this has been continued for the 10 years and is also.Will also be continued, and we see now how it changes that the many areas are now turning blue, which means that the radiation is getting lower.
そうね。じゃあ、ありがとう。あ、もう少しあるんですか？
はい。はい、
A little more. Yeah.
ここが、あの、原発爆発して1年後くらい、ね、で、除染をして、除染をして、で少しずつ少しずつ線量が下がっているっていう、これも場所によって全然違う下がり方をするんですね。
At the beginning at the top, you can see it's 1 to 2 years after the accident, and a lot of remediation has been done. Then you can see the large drop, and then slowly, slowly, the radiation is declining.But this is also, this change is also different、from place to place. It varies a lot.
まあ、あの、中立なセーフキャストで、オープンハードウェア、オープンソフトウェアっていうところに惹かれて、今も私も所属して、一生懸命ワークショップをお手伝いしています。よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。あの渡辺さんと渡辺さん、ビッグとスモール渡辺っていうことなんですけど、私たちからも、あの、私たち一緒に10年間でいろいろあって、いろいろ一緒にやったことがすごく、あの、いい大事な、あの、ことなんで、本当にありがとうございました。これからももちろん、あの、まあ、こういう変な話なんですけど、こういうことで友達になっていることというのがもう事実なんで、いろいろこういう、まあ、第一がとかいろいろなかったから、私たちはとも別の生活いてて、でもすごく重要なあの友達になって、一緒にあのたくさん の郡山市とか福島市の子どもたちと一緒にいろいろやったりとか、あとは、まあ、たまに飲み会も楽しくて、それもぜひも続きたいと、あとはあの音楽もみんなが好きだし、今日は本当に渡辺さんたちのためにいろいろ の、まあ、いい音楽を聞きながら、いい思いと悪い思いにもあると思うんですけど、それを将来を向かって若い人たち で僕はあの渡辺則夫さんに対してがすごく素晴らしいことが、本当にその学生たちをすごく守って、すごくサポートして、本当に会った時にも本当に素晴らしいあの生徒と思いましたので、それがもう私たちもそのために頑張ったりとか、すごくいい気分がになったと思います。で、それで本当にありがとうございます。
Peter, will you repeat that in English, please?
Yes, I can. So I would like to...really thank, you know, maybe as Asbi explained, Vic and Small Watanabe, and I'm kind of the guilty one to come up with all these names because I sometimes forget names, but I like to give people descriptive names that I can somewhat remember. But Big Watanabe, I met Big Watanabe on my first trip to Fukushima literally 10 years ago. And I'll never forget that moment because we were so...you know, we were going into the unknown, and we were going to Koriyama, and we were introduced to you through friends. And from that moment on, you know, all our lives changed, and we had an experience. I really would like to thank you for all your support through the years, and going forward, we want to definitely continue that. And what I said about Norio Watanabe, he is an amazing school teacher. We have been working with his classes in Fukushima for the last many, many years, and I worked with his students, and I'm always so impressed. What he does for his students is really remarkable, and some of those students, you know, really got opportunities to participate with us, but we also gave us a lot of the strength and inspiration to do what we're doing today. We're now doing this for 10 years, And we really want to continue this journey, specifically for younger generations, to encourage them to inquire, to create transparency, but also to learn new things as they happen from these disasters. We can strengthen ourselves. So I really would like to thank our boat Watanabes for being such strong supporters and collaboration together over the years. So, motto hontou ni arigatou gozaimashita.
Arigatou gozaimashita. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, and I just wanted to check, Asbi, if we're kind of cool. We're cool with the discussion. I have some one more thing.
Yeah.
One more thing. Kelsey, is our special guest ready to be dropping in, or what's the story?
あとはまあ一つだけあのあれね。だから、
no, yes, one more thing to say.
Yeah. Yes, どうぞぜひよろしくお願いします。はい。う
ん、あのまあ10年は経つんだけども、結局まあなんでしょうね。あの先月も2月13日に大きい地震が福島でありました。だからやっぱり remember 3.11、don't remember 3.11、and やっぱりその何まだまだ通過点っていうの。あのまあ、40年は廃炉にかかると言われているので、やっぱり10年は経ったけども、まだまだやっぱり、あの、道半ばっていうか、それでやっぱり地震があるたんびに、あの、原発が壊れるんじゃないかみたいなね。そういう、いつもやっぱり地震、大きい地震あると、やっぱ原発、まあ60キロぐらい離れてるんだけど、ここは。やっぱ原発がどうなったかっていうのはすごく心配に、なるのは今も変わりませんね。
Okay. So he's saying that, you know, 10 years have passed, but even just a month ago, we had another strong earthquake. And he just says, remember 311, remember this, we can't forget it. You know, there's lots of earthquakes here. There's lots of nuclear power plants. You know, I guess basically it could happen again. And we always have to think about this. And this process of decommissioning the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear reactor is said to will take 40 years. Actually, we don't know how long. That's a long time. You know, 10 years has passed, but that's only one little part of it. It's going to continue for a very, very long time. So let's always keep that in mind and be prepared for the eventuality of another accident. Arigato.
Arigato gozaimasu. Mata chikai uchi de yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Mata.
Thanks. Thank you. Arigato.
Hi. Thank you.
Thank you. So, thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you.
Maybe we can go ahead and drive.
To... Please, また stay on the し、またなんか話が出ればまた参加してください。
So, Peter, we are
going
to start to drive to our next.
Separate and
we're going to start to drive to Ukedo.
Yes. So, how do radiation levels? What are the radiation levels we're right now where you are?
Yeah. Okay. Joe's checking. Yeah. Hang on.
Check.
I'm just gonna look at the GeigerCast.
He's gonna look at the GeigerCast online.
Okay. Yeah. The thing is, this funny thing is, it's opposite to me in the other screen. So I can't really grab it, but.
So we're back in.
For everybody who's watching in the YouTube stream, if you look below the stream in the description, you'll find the link to what is called GeigerCast. This is a live stream of the car. And if you watch this later in time, you can go back in time and find that data. So this is live being live streamed here.
So can you see?
Yes, we can see that.
So this was the early part of the day. This is when we are sitting in front of Fukushima Daiichi.
Right. So
how high we are now.
So what was the highest peak you had roughly there? Was it 2.5 or 2.5 microsieverts an hour?
One peak is about three microsieverts an hour.
About three microsieverts an hour.
Three microsieverts an hour, right? Yes. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know exactly that you know where we were driving there 10 years ago, but I remember in that area it was in the tens.
The tens, multiple tens of microsieverts.
Multiple tens of microsievert. I remember it, you know, together with Joe, and we went into the Nami area where we head up to 50-100 microsievert hotspots and everything. So
On 399, the highest we had that time, Peter, was 80.
Yeah, so it's hard to explain, you know, 10 years ago, but I can tell you that, you know, those were expeditions that, you know, we did it with gusto, but things have changed, things have come down in these areas, but even today, there are still a very long story ahead of us. So where are you going next to, guys? What's up next?
one town a little bit further north, it's really only like a 5 minute drive or 10 minute drive, is Ukedo in Namie.
Okay.
And we're actually in Futaba now, so we will be in Namie. And right. This is similar. It was destroyed by a tsunami and also had a radioactive fallout. And there's some old school that the building is still existing as kind of a very damaged ruin. We'll take a look at that and talk about what's happening with that. And then we'll go look at one or two other places. So we'll be on the road a bit. And I will occasionally point the phone, point the camera out the window.